Hi buddy, welcome back to Manor and Brass episode 7 with me, Sid, and I've been busy since the last episode. I do come on regular and just finagle away at things, and just loving this. I'm kind of getting mixed results from this space. Certain items seem to work with this system, and other items seem not to work. This, for example, did not seem to be working. Now, I don't know whether it's because it wasn't connected properly here. I'm not sure, but I'm not going to worry about it. For example, the vault is not showing down there. We had that brief moment where it said we've got like 40-odd thousand slots. We know stuff is being stored in it, so let's not worry about it. When this tells me it's full, we'll live with it. Anyway, let us run up here. And I've tidied up a little bit more up here. We have a schematic table from Create now. I also have the botany table. That was a new table that I didn't have. There's one more I think I need, which is a gem table. Not too worried about that. Made a study desk, and I have used up all my torn research notes. These things, because, yeah, you don't need them. What else have I done? We've got the kitchen is still the kitchen. I've made myself some teas, and I have got lots and lots of foodie stuff in here, and everything is fine and dandy and good. Water source block down there. I can't remember whether I'm trying to remember what I've done, what I've showed you, and what I haven't. Now, in terms of the portal, it's still there. It's still big. It's I've trimmed back a few of these glowberry vines, and yeah, it is doing what I intended it to do. It's a portal. I have started with a path up to the nether roof. So I've, on the other side of there, there's now a little bit. I've also been to a nether fortress because I wanted to get these because I would like to be able to cure my villagers. Well, first of all, I'd like to infect my villagers with the zombie disease and then cure them. And if I can just go and throw myself in here. Over here, I have started with some, excuse me, Mr. Salmon, some more garden plots, and some, we got some tea going now. So these obviously I'm just coming out and harvesting the grown carrots in this case, and then popping them in. That's all good. The tea grows. You snip that off with a blah, 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 shears. Got more seeds to plant in here. Flax, cabbage, onions, beetroots. Over here I have got tomatoes. Just a small field again. And they're all manual. There's nothing fancy to these. There will be something fancy to them at some point. And I need to put paths in and keep expanding out this area over here. I keep putting the seeds in with the chickens. The chickens are taking anti-gramming damage and dying. And everything's good over here. We need to sort out what we do with animals as well. So what's going on over here, of course, is I've got a hovering hourglass firing the eggies into here to make the babies, and when the babies come in, certain ones die, and the entity cramming comes in, and yeah, we get raw chicken. Lovely. But yeah, just stuff. Nothing major. In terms of building and decorating, do need to do some work over there, and I've got a little few things I need to do over here, just two things, because we've got this fella. This fella is a grave guardian. He spawns around the graves. I had him trapped in the graveyard, but one of the graves is too close to the wall, and I think he used that to climb out. So, yeah, that was a thing. But the good news is I have all of my gear. We're fully enchanted. As much as I'm going to be. Got a nice sharpness 5, tombstone soul by mending and breaking sword. We've got all of that stuff. I've got a decent efficiency axe. I've got a silk touch mending efficiency soul bound blah 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 thingy. I never bothered enchanting the hoe, and I've got a little bit of golden helmet. Now you, don't get into a fight with this guy, but you can trade with him. And at the moment I've traded him up to apprentice level. I do need to trade some more. I'm not going to waste my gunpowder on him though. Because I have invested some time in a creative world creating some more buildings, and obviously down here I have my toolsmiths, my weaponsmiths and my armourers, and what I would like to do is start building the houses, which everything is in there that I need for this. I have created the schematic. I have got the book. There's a couple of things missing. Grass blocks and villager spawn eggs. I can live with that. I don't know how much we need to put in. That is enough for 2,000 shots. That may be enough. I want to skip missing blocks and let's start off with this. I have worked out where everything was. That was a thing. Love this thing. It's relatively inexpensive to use and doesn't, in my honest opinion, it doesn't save that much time, because I still had to go and create all of this, and it's actually quite tedious going through the book going, oh, what do I need now, what do I need next, what do I need now, and it's a bit of an interesting one. But this is an armourer's building. I've created an armourer's, weaponsmiths, toolsmiths, I think, masons, which I haven't got yet, farm, which I haven't done yet. But again, I'm not going to go mad and just pile everything in. This is going to be a slow process where we build up the property as it goes, and we will do that. Now I want to get him back in. He should be trapped, and he should be trapped in here. As I say, he's trapped by that. That should stop him. But I think he jumped onto here and just climbed over like that, because that's the only way I can think of that he could have got out. So I do need to get him back in. But this is good, because it means I can experiment with a build style and a build palette in away from the things. Okay. What's he on about now? It's an 8-block sphere. What? I'm not sure what Pops is on about. We'll find out in a moment though. Because apparently it's an 8-block sphere. Not an 8-block rate, we know it's the thing. Anyway, this is doing its thing. Should start building up quite happily. I don't know why it's not put the doors in yet, but that's fine. And once this is in, I need lava, because that's missing. But that is orientated incorrectly. The armor stand hasn't placed. But again, doesn't matter, because this is still faster than me having to go and keep pictures of these things and then go and reconstruct it on here. And and do it, but not a lot faster, it's got to be said, but it is faster. Actually, to be fair, it probably is a lot faster, but you know, it's got those in. I don't probably remember what was on half of these. We'll soon find out, because we'll find out what's left in the oh, it's done the doors. Okay, cool. What have you not got? You didn't get the banner. And I did definitely said I definitely had two of them. Oh, there you go, it doesn't matter. That's fine. That's fine. I do want to get one of those. Everything else is placed all right, but we do need to, well, we need to do those. And those will go like so, stopping anything from jumping in. Reed villager. Big chain, little light source, everything's good like that. This is all nice in here and sorted. Perfect. Chest. Yeah, that's fine. What I do need is a cheap ass what have you got? Let me got lots of emeralds. I've been trading with them fish guys, like they're going out of fashion. There you go, that will do. And pop those away. Hup. And obviously we still need to put a path road coming over here. That's going to, the road's going to come along from there. I'm going to have a like a town square in the middle, so we'll get that sorted. But these are quite nice, because you get to do that, and it looks, just gives it that something about it that I think looks better than the alternatives. Right, lava, and we're good. Let me go and grab those. I'll be back in a second. All right, got the lava. We shall come and pop it in, and that should give us a nice... I have to go and get another piece of armour off of one of these fellas. I need to actually trade with one of them anyway, so... we could get some chain boots for a single. That kind of works, doesn't it, actually? I mean, I could... Yeah, we'll go with the chain boots, because I don't need to spend a lot to get these. Now, who's got the best? I don't think any of them are... You, okay, you can kidnap. Pow, thank you. You can come and live up here. And what I will do is, let me have a look here. There we go. Thank you. Borrow that. Grab you. We can come up there. That can go in there. I think that will work. Yes. Bit of dirt. Dirty dirt. Of the dirt that destroyed, actually, that's an interesting question. Not a vastly interesting question, admittedly, but still a bit of an interesting question. Yeah, that can go there, and that's just dusty gravel. That's fine. We've now got our entrance down to the traders down there. Once we've done this properly, we will there we go. Yeah, a pair of boots. And I gave them a little toolbox as well. I actually did give them a crate, which for some reason didn't actually translate over either. And you can't get out, can you? No, you can't. I can, however. Yeah. Where did the... Where did the grave go? Oh, he's there. Okay. So, the other thing I need to do desperately is I need to get this guy back in. But I do want to do it in such a way. Let's just try... Don't want to accidentally... Oh, damn it. I don't want to accidentally hit him with... because he looks pretty damn hard. But that's fine. He's safe for a moment. So I need to do something with that scrave. I don't really want to waste the soul. So empty schematic. Okay, that's perfect. We can use you again. Lovely. Yes, let me go and... He's probably quicker to teleport from the church back over home. Yeah, nice. We've got these things. We just need to get him back in and we're happy. But that's really easy. Da, 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 da. Oh, yeah, you need to move definitely down off the bottom, as do you. Because that was where I went hunting. It's amazing how brave I get when... let me just shunt that up. Previous blah, blah, blah. But that can come down. This is just where I've been exploring. And there is a really nice graveyard that... No. Damn it. There. Right. Yeah, but again... There's only so many things I can do in an episode, so I do have to be a little bit cautious now. If I want to make myself a tablet, I have a tablet, which I don't trust, because it's something evil emanates, can bring you fortune, even if you have returned. Sounds scary. Oh, I might do it one day, but you know, not right now. So I want one of those, and I think, oh, I've actually got enough. That's fine. And then I need some bone meal. And you craft that by combining it in your inventory. That gives me a tablet of recall, which is similar to that. And then we can go back over to here. Borrow that soul. That now has three uses, but these are really cheap for what they are. Some things won't allow you to dig spell them, and this is one of them. But what we want to do is we want to take you back there. I'll borrow that. Again, if these are not important, I don't need to have these in place, but I think they had a certain je ne sais quoi, and it just means that Mr. Guardian Boy over there hasn't got any opportunities to get up onto this wall, and I'm kind of just checking there's nowhere else he could have done that. He's not, none of these are not like climbable. That's not climbable. He couldn't have done it from there. No, it had to be that. That's the only point that he could have done that in, so that's fine. Borrow a bit of them. you can tell Theo you've got too much. Oh, hello. Let me just do that for now. Right, so we need to get this fella over here. I've not got powered rails, we'll just do it the hard way. And I haven't got that many rails either, which who's that down there? If he's head. Oh, it's Mr. Drowny Boy, okay. Not working for you, is it? Oh, well, stop bouncing. What did you just drop? Oh, a familiar stone, okay. plenty of those. Still need to work out what we can do with those, but that's fine. Let's just continue and put a block there. We shall pop you down and go get you over there, and then just keep moving him. And once he's in place, then we hopefully won't have a problem with him wandering around the town anymore. I want to keep him because, you know, he's a member of the community. A valued member of the community, shall we say. Right. Bang. Pop that there. Oh, of course. It's emerald, isn't it? that's probably the wrong thing to be using then, but... Oh, that's not going to play nicely. Okay. Yeah, I need to think this through a bit more. So you're going to come up here, go around, over and down, and then round and down. Oh god, this is going to be messy. Well, let's get him up to here first. That's going to be a challenge enough, I think. Because we need to get him up. Oh, okay. Fine. Yeah, anyway, I'm going to continue putting this guy here back where he belongs. And I'll be back in a short while. All right, he's in. I'm deliberately not sleeping through the night, by the way, because one of the spell components you often need for mana and artifice is Phantom Membrane, and I'm down to the last one. So I'm hoping I can get a little bit of Phantom Spawnage at some point over the next few nights, if... things, but we'll see where he goes. He should in theory be trapped in there now, and I do want to cover this hole over at some point as well. And I thought we had somebody showing up down here, but clearly not. Maybe despawned, who knows. So what else have we got to do? I do want to push my magic mastery forward a little bit this episode as well. Mainly because I can, if I'm brutally honest, but also because, you know, we need to focus on the magic. I'm going to start playing around with some of the other magic mods, the blood magic. Blood magic, I've already done a bit of Batania anyway, but I'd like to have a go with the Enchanted, because that, if you excuse me, I've got a little bit of a cold, so yeah, the old nose is streaming a bit now and again. Not live streaming, fortunately. Oh, that doesn't bear thinking about, does it? But I want to push that forward, and I also want to get the library built. So, you know, every episode, as far as I'm concerned, there should be a little bit further forward with the things. That also needs a place, but I really haven't got anywhere to keep it right now. Let's start over in the box, because I've done some preparations, and this lot here will basically, there are certain things you need to do, but we need to add a mod, we need to add a modifier, use a spell using a ritual of alteration. We will come to that one. Apply a patch to a practitioner's pouch. Well, I have a practitioner's pouch. Unfortunately, it's a good practitioner's pouch, so, and I'm not sure whether this will count, but it's already got quite a few of the patches on. It's got depth. It's got depth 2. It doesn't have void. It doesn't have speed 1, 2, and 3. It doesn't have glyph. It doesn't have moat. It doesn't have weave. So I need to make a moat patch. And this particular thing here, when used in a ritual with a quadrum, and these other two items will make me a moat patch. So, in theory, this should. This should. Make me a moat patch. And then I need to remember how you apply that. So it's not a crafting thing. I don't think you just do you. Oh, okay. Maybe I had that already. Oh, maybe I can't apply a moat patch to this. Maybe I need to make myself a bag of hoofrator first. Damn it. It's always trying to catch me out. Okay, let's have a look at a practitioner's pouch. Should be cheap enough. Oh, I need to make some of that. Okay, we need to make one of those. Okay. And that's nice and cheap. And then if we get you, and you don't do it like that. Right, what you do is you get your book and you learn how to do it. Rituals, probably. Moats, practitioner's powers, blah, blah, blah. Oh, we need a sorcerer's sewing kit, that's right. Hold to go, activating power sufficiently, but patches most of the things. Ability, same functionality. By patch, place the patch down on a runic anvil. So we need one of those. Then place the patch on top of it. Finally, activate the anvil with a sorcerer's sewing set. Okay. So we need an anvil first. Runesmithing. Blank plates, rune scribing, that's your thingy, rune smithing, there we go, runic anvil. That should be relatively easy. A runic anvil. Oh, we don't have an anvil. Easily fixed. Almost easily fixed. Doop. And dupe, and bang. And again, we shall pop you just down there for now. And then I need to make a sorcerer's sewing thing, which requires an infused thread and a vitium. Oh, God. Yeah, these things are never simple, are they? Because we need a vitium needle, which means I need a vitium needle pattern. But before I do that, I need a rune smithing. A rune scribing table, which I need to get my pick out because there was an unfortunate dupe bug in this where if you use a break spell on a chipped table, it dupes it. I'm not in a position to fix it because I'm not sure what's causing the dupe, but it's a fairly minor dupe, so I just remember that we don't need to do that, otherwise we'll get that. Right, I need a chisel and a hammer, so we need a runesmith's hammer. I don't need a runesmith's hammer, I've got the hammer, haven't I? Yes. So we don't need you, that goes in there, but I do need a runesmith's chisel. And I don't have a Vintium ingot, so that is simple. That is that and some iron. If I can just find myself one of those, and then we can take that and that and place that over here in you. Cook. And while we're waiting on that, I'm going to need a plate. No, a rune plate. These things. Need one of those. I'm going to need some clay. which we'll just grab that. And that goes in there. And while we're at it, we then want the runes. So, pardon me for snifflies. We need a rune of defense. Claw. Marking. Rod. Aura. Again, you don't need to go to these lengths. I think we've got defense already. Torso. You can just go and... In fact, we could just do this. Yeah, do it. Oh, hello, not you. It really doesn't mind. We're just going to go and pump all of those in there. And the problem is these are not in any order and makes life a little bit awkward. But not a problem. I don't even know. I may not even have a Vitium needle. But there we go. That's simple enough. We just need to find the Vitium needle and mundane ring, arcane, axe, Vitium needle. There you go. We'll take that. So we're going to do that, but we do need the chisel. Oops. There we go. So that's the first step, and then we can go and make so we've got you, and then you go on there, and then I need some Vitium ingot, and then I need to superheat it, so give me a little bit of that, going to go and do that, that will go there, need to borrow the hammer, which of course is good because it doesn't use any durability. And yeah, come on, you can do it. Takes a while. And once this is done, we put it on again. That will give us a superheated, which we put on top of that and hammer it in, and we get the needle. And you also do need the thread, don't I? So that one, and that is infused silk and Vitium. So an infused silk and some, oops, hello, Vitium. Take you off, pop you on, off you go. You go in there along with that. And it is up right fishy, up left fishy even. I feel sorry for the Mithian. He comes up with all these lovely names for the things, and then I just go and call them up left fishy. You only got one use out of that. That's interesting. And then the usage of that is just combine the two together. Okay. Then we take you. And we take you. And we do that. Oops, hello. Give me that back. Come on. Thank you. And there's our spare practitioner's pouch, which I'm not going to worry about. I don't need it for anything. This is just advancing that forward. Now that should have also rune forged a rune and rune scribed a rune pattern. So we got three things out of that, which is pretty good. We need 15, and now we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So I now need 6, of which there are another 4, or another 3, I should say, here. Actually, there are 4. So let me just have a look what we're going to do with you. We are going to make a book of alteration. That's the beastie. Okay. So that, and that, and the book of alteration is square down left fishy, circle up left fishy. Square down left fishy, circle. No, circle. No, circle. How round do you want? Come on. Circle. Up left fishy while we're at it, might as well. Oh man, this nose is starting to get annoyingly dribbly. There's our book of alteration. I don't think that gave me anything because you have to use the book of alteration. So we'll come back to that one in a moment. So we're going to grab this lot and chimerite. I don't think you're doing it through that. I think it's in here, and we are doing not chimerite crystals. Eventually, somewhere in this lot, there's a thing. Come on. No. All right, it's a mana crystal. So let's go and have a look at that. We'll look it up the other way. Mana crystal. So mana crystal is made up of mana crystal fragments. Mana crystal, blah, blah, blah. Oh, okay. So it is like that. So it's one of those. And one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight of those. And then Orbius, circle diamond, square diamond. Okay. Let's do this way, but that way we can get it. Circle. Boom. Circle. Diamond. Square. Diamond. There is a mana crystal fragment, and what we're going to do is go to 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and that should have made a mana crystal. Now, the mana crystal requires a mote of magic, so we ain't got that yet. So, but that is a step closer to those. It doesn't say that they have to be charged either, does it? We'll come back to the moat in a moment. This one, we'll take it. I don't know where to put this guy. But it does require me to make a golem with stone or wooden parts. So we'll just come and take him out here, and we'll just let him stand in the courtyard for a bit, you know, as you do. Let me find my armor stand. Boop. So a wicker head, wicker leggies, stone torso, stone arm, wooden. Oh, hang on. Yeah, then we need to do alter the orientation of that. Bang. Wow. that little backpack you've got there. Don't know what you're going to do with you, but we'll cross that bridge when we come to it. May just chuck him in a pool of lava. Nope, didn't hear that. Right, so that should be another task off of this list. Is it? Yes, it is. So how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Four more to go. That is one. Using this will be two. And third one is up here. And I've already got the ritual drawn out. So what we need to do is we're going to take this. We're going to activate. Now this is a projectile frost damage. It uses a hell of a lot of stuff, which is all in here. And I don't think I've got quite enough inventory space to hold all of this in one go. But fine, we'll work our way through. No, that's not that sword. Okay, let me just make sure that I've not. Yep, of course I have. Yeah, I've got you, got gold sword, snowball, red rune, white rune. Another red rune somewhere, apparently. There. Sword. Focus. Focus. What am I missing? Blue rune and a... Well, there's a blue rune. I'm missing a rune. There you go. A cyan rune. And that should be everything to make a complexity, a spell with a complexity greater than 25. Upside downy triangle. Squircle. And I'm just going to call this Frost Bolt, I think. Alright, I've made the ring. Now I've got a sneaking suspicion that the ring will not work for this. But it may. It did. Okay. Rune scribing recipe, mundane ring. Okay, that's good. And we need to do with the thing with the oculus. Now, I did make a pattern for defense. I don't need to worry about that then because it wasn't necessary. So, yeah, that was surprising. And I do have a ring which we can make a ring of breaking with using that 3 iron and some Vintium. So we may as well do that anyway. Vintium and iron. Oops, helps if I can type. Need to just break down a block. So that's 1, 2, 3, and the rest can go back. So I'm going to pop you in, and then 1, 2, 3. And that should give me the ring of lesser breaking, which is 2 Adamas. Think I should be able to get those. Apparently not. Let's just try that again, because I might have just been still on that one. to. So that gives us the ring of lesser the breaking, which doesn't require charging. We just put it in a ring slot, and now our break spell is the next level up, which I think off the top of my head is going to be iron level. So I should be able to break diamond but not break obsidian. That's all very good. Now what does it do? Blah blah, change the affinity, have an active set, advance by following, completing one of the following. So this is where we need to choose our thing. Now the one I am going to go with is a ritual of the fairy court. However, I am probably not going to do it this episode, mainly because I probably haven't got, well, let's have a look. Ritual of the Wizard's Council, Wandering Wizard on Town, Burning on your Steps, Fairy Courts. Yeah, so we need to get a moat of air and a moat of water, so there's some preparation to do. The moat of air we need to do well up in the air, and the moat, we go into here. Where are we? We've got the moat of air, Untamed Wilds and Searing Inferno, not Searing Inferno, Untamed Wilds and Ancient Stone. They're the two. That has to be deep underground near bedrock, so we're going to need to get down there. It's not a problem, I've got a space, I just need to dig it out. But the moat of Untamed Wilds, wasn't it? Untamed Wind, sorry. That needs to be formed while high above the clouds. So we need to create basically two ritual areas to do that. So that is going to do us on that side of things. Let's go and think about libraries, as we tend to do. So what I've got here right now is a mess. It's an unpleasant, unmitigated disaster of a mess. So what I want here is, for starters, I don't want this in oak. So we'll take that lot out, because the library is going to be pretty much done entirely in spruce. So the first thing I need to do is go and get some spruce. I've got loads of spruce. I went and chopped a load down prior to this episode because I knew I was going to need a lot of spruce. It's almost like I planned it. So let's go with the spruce. Bookshelves, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. I'll do 16 just in case I need an odd number. And let's go and work out how we're going to do this, because I want it to look nice, you know, for obvious reasons. I could move you on that and have it die. Yeah, let's do that for starters. So we shall place the clock here. Like so. And we can build our things around that. That is empty, so you can go straight back into storage. That has got my Smite 5 sword. This is my Wither sword. That wants to go in there. I do need to sort this out big time. That is a spare sword, so that can just go away. And then that is all books and stuff, so that can just come over here. You can come over there for the time being. And the spare diamond armor set can come over and, well, I suppose for want of a better place for it, let's just plonk it out here for now. It's completely unenchanted. It was a big enough pain getting all of this lot ready, so. And I don't know whether I do have the mod that adds the sword on. Okay, that's fine. You can go do like that for now. You do you. Right, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. I think that works. And then we take you, plonk you there, and you should, if I go and find something that's unenchanted, take that, and you'll give me a level 30 enchant. Perfect. So that gives us that. I think I'm going to make you part of the decor. And I think I will probably also make these part of the decor. I'll stick another one of those and it gives me the symmetry. And then I need, what do I need going around here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. That'd be 32 less 1, 31 spruce bordered blocky things. Yeah. That's a technical term, by the way. Spruce bordered blocky things. Let me grab some more spruce. Take 31 of those and carpenter's table. What have we got? What is going to look like a pegged spruce planks? That could work. What I'm trying to say is what's going to look like the kind of the panelling that you would get in a library. And I think either these, I think I'm going to go there actually. I think that will work. Because the library is also going to get all of my, casting desks. My manor and artifice desk, or most of them, maybe not all of them. That might be a little bit overly optimistic. Bonk, and while we're at it, do we keep an anvil in here? I mean, that kind of makes sense in its own twisted way. Okay, that's good. So if I'm going across from here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Count it. I'm just going to go and count some bulk blocks, and I'm going to go and get some spruce stairs. They're going to be the top part of it. I'll be back in a sec. Okay, I think we're about there. I've transferred all the books up. There's a few bits and pieces I want to put in just to make it look nicer, but and obviously we need a lot more books and everything to really fill this up. These shelves here, the item shelves, will have more stuff on them. So at the moment, they're just the only thing I've got on there is, you know, this stuff. But let's just get myself just somewhere to study, and I'm going to put down this, which is fantasy carpet, hence why, you know, A, it doesn't sound like carpet, and B, things. But we got these up here. I know there are more of these things. We've got our Oculus, and you know, it's supposed to look cluttered. I'm going for that Victorian clutter, which was apparently a thing. We've got a little block box there. As I say, I can put a lot of odds and ends up here. So realistically, for example, if we run down here, there's a whole load of co-rail tombstone bits and pieces, which, again, if we look at these individual items that are not stacking, that, for example, is part of the graveyard mod. There's another two parts to that. You've got that tablet, these scrolls. Gives you here at the village too for 11 minutes. And these are really actually quite powerful. We've got this wand I kept because I was quite amused by its power, as I was saying with that rift spell, for example. We've got this stuff from Frost gave me, I think it was Frost who gave me that. Forgive me if I got that wrong. It was a while ago now. And then these we need to work out what we're going to do, but all of this random gubbins can be stored on those shelves, and it'll add to that clutter. It will make it look that a little bit more lived and populated than if we just left it bare. For want of a better word. Again, we could put a couple of maps up on the wall as well. We could take a couple of the shelves down and just put a couple of the treasure maps up just to make them look that way. So, something I might do. Don't know where. I mean, that's got our fishing books in. There's no rhyme or reason to how I've done this as well. I've tried to be fairly random with it. So, but you do need to find the right point and then chuck in a whole load of scrolls. And that's a bookshelf, that's not. So we can chuck those in. Over here, I can chuck in, not that, that's my actual thing. I can chuck those in, for example, and get a couple of ones on the shelves. It's really just to give that feel of mess and just general disorganization. But it will be easy to find them, which is pretty important. So let me just do a little bit more shuffling around in there, and hopefully that room will be, well, done for the time being, shall we say. Back in a mo. All right, and with that, I think we are about done for this episode. I'm happy with the progress. We've managed to push ourselves on in wizardry. We have now got a library home. I may move that yet, but doesn't really work up there, so might move it, say, over here or there even. In fact, let's do that now. If I can. So boom, and pop that over there. We'll whack you there. That gives us, it's not a complete treasure map, which gives us that kind of nice torn effect. And that's our fishing rod bits. So all good there. I am happy with. This is nice and confused and really just messy, and I like it. I'm easily pleased. Next episode, we are going to move to tier 3, probably. I also do want to do some work in the Nether first, though, and moving to tier 3 is going to put me at odds with both of the factions that exist in the Nether. So I may hold fire a little another episode before I make that commitment. We are going to sort out the roof in here. We are going to sort out the roof in here. And we are probably going to put a bedroom or something in here. I don't know. But definitely get the roofs sorted down there. I may try and get the dining room done first. I don't know. It's, swings. Six one half dozen t'other. And we'll get another few more buildings. Maybe I'll, get a couple more lined up. ready to go over here so we can continue building up Port Valentine and getting this done. Now, I have got a plan to do some boats, and I will admit upfront that I'm going to steal them, but I am going to steal them the sensible way. And I'm sure if you haven't worked out what that is, you will have by the time I do it. But on that note, thank you very much for watching, guys. He's obviously still nicely stuck over there, which is good. Oh, we have actually got a spot I need to sort out, but for now we'll just do that. I should remember to do that every time I go and do anything in the surrounding land, because yeah, the moment I change anything, it alters the lighting, and the moment I change the lighting, things become spawnable. But here's need to ch do some more trading with this guy as well. I might go and get some snowballs, stuff like that. I'd like the opposite trade, actually. In fact, is there a way to get phantom membranes other than from phantoms? No, that is the only option. Okay. So I'm going to have to hover around outside and just hope that we get some phantomy goodness at some point. But until next time, thank you very much for watching, guys, and I will see you soon. Bye for now.